We're back with a real interview this time. This guy is insane, guys. He's such an awesome artist and a sketcher and a painter. He's been all around the world for his artworks.
No, I haven't.
He's been in Europe for his artworks.
No, not there.
North America.
Sorry, no.
South America.
Not outside of the continent of Africa.
So just South Africa?
Yeah, pretty much.
Not even Antarctica?
No.
Well, he's big in South Africa. Or just Gauteng. But he's going to be big because this guy's awesome, guys. So the dude we're interviewing today, his name is Michael Anderson. And we're going to show you his skills and we're going to interview him, of course. Just look at his room. It's insane. You can see the artistic brain in him, if I can put it that way. Holy shit, check out this thing. This thing is sick. Guys, how cool is this? Right there. And that's just like a snippet of what's to come for this interview with Michael Anderson. Don't forget his name is Michael Anderson, and he's an artist, as you can see right there. All of that is Michael Anderson. But that doesn't look, that's not him, if you're thinking. That's some random guy. But that's not Michael Anderson, okay.
So we're here with Michael Anderson, ready to ask him about his artworks, which I just had a look through and was incredible. Tell us about your colors. Do you like your watercolors? Do you prefer acrylic, oil, what's up?
I use whatever's going at the time. I usually just mix media. So I'll start out with pencil drawing, maybe I'll even draw it in pen. And then, yeah, throw paint at it. I don't really like to use oil that much because it's quite messy and takes ages to dry. But yeah, I use whatever's going.
Sweet. And just having a look around your room, I see the fairies there at the top. We've got your really awesome bust sculpture here of you with horns, which is pretty sick. I'm just wondering, your favorite genre, would that thing be fantasy?
I never really thought about that. Like, I just paint whatever comes to me at the time or draw. At the moment I'm busy with a lot of commissions, so it's more about applying my own style and making something look cool rather than the whole idea behind it. But sometimes I will get a cool idea and be like, I'm gonna paint that.
Very, very, very cool. Portraits or landscapes?
Well, most of my work in there is portraits, but at the moment I'm kind of trying to shy away from the portrait and do something a bit different. But I can't get away from using people in my work. I always have to like add the human element to it. I feel that it connects people to the artwork, and it's also easier to show emotion in a face.
Talking about emotion, I'd just like to show you guys this picture. I think, Michael, you capture emotion in a painting or a picture very, very well. I don't think a lot of artists are able to picture, put in an emotion on a person's face, but rather in the painting as a whole. Now let's talk about these two awesome pictures. This one was done in high school, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what was the theme?
The theme was journey, and yeah, that's what they used to do. They used to just give us a simple word and we could elaborate with it. And yeah, this is pretty much, yeah, that's pretty much it. She's on a train.
having a journey.
Yeah.
And then lastly, Michael, I just want to ask you to talk to us about this cool painting. Wait, is it painting? Is it?
It's mixed media. As I was saying earlier, it's
pastel.
There's pastel there, there's ink, there's paint. Yeah.
So tell us about it. What was your idea behind it? I know artists mainly about like emotion, but can you tell us a bit about it?
Well, this is a picture of a lady I've seen a few times and met once or twice as well. Her name is Cindy, and yeah, she does art as well, but she's quite into the whole alternative scene, heavy metal. You know, she dresses in the typical heavy metal attire, and then on Facebook, I saw a selfie she posted for the no makeup selfie thing, and I thought it was so different from the, you know, makeup and stuff that you usually see it in. And yeah, I just want you to take this, do this juxtaposing of someone who's usually all gothed up and make it absolutely ridiculous and bright.
That's great. That's awesome. And how long did it take you to do it?
It took me about a month and a bit, but that's, yeah, not from start to finish. It's like working on it an hour here, 2 hours here, 20 minutes here.
Awesome. That's, no, I must say, Michael, like, looking around, you have awesome sculptures, awesome pictures. I appreciate that we have someone like you.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, cool.
Now that the boring part is over, kidding, that was actually interesting. Myself, I'm not a very autistic person, and I'd like to say that your work is pretty damn cool, dude.
Thanks, man.
I can't do any of this, I can't draw stick men, so this is awesome. Okay, so what is with the hair?
It's my trademark, I guess.
But I've seen it everywhere. My girls.
Yeah, but like, Not a lot of guys have the long hair thing, and it's a conversation starter as well. You know, if you just walk into a place looking normal, you know, but then you walk into a place where everybody's like, oh my gosh, your hair!
Is that the girl speaking there?
Yeah.
Just looking at this piece of art, I get like you have a very sexual feel to your artwork. Like, there's a very certain type of sexuality that goes on in it. What can you say about that? Like,
well, that's actually a very important part of my artwork, because for me, when it comes to music, art, expression, love making, it all comes from the same place. And art is very often an expression of lust and sexual dynamism. Yes.
What is this word, dynamism?
Something explosive.
Okay, now I know you like a fan of a selfie, like you're a fan of selfies, and I must say, there's one picture that I'm looking at, your body in person looks quite different. So does your face and everything. So would you like to explain to the viewers what the concept is behind this?
Well, that is not me at all, but the whole concept of the selfie is pretty interesting, because back in the day, before cameras even, people would get portraits painted themselves, and people still get portraits painted of themselves. But this whole concept of social media and it being much easier to send photos to people and see images such as this, I decided that I'm gonna work with that idea and just start painting these absolutely unflattering yet cool pictures that people send each other. You know, because it takes the idea of beauty to a whole new level. I mean, this isn't an attractive lady, and yet there's something tacky yet beautiful about, you know, a selfie in an untidy room in a dirty mirror.
Are you a nymphomaniac?
Pretty much, yeah. I'm saying that on the internet. Terrible.
Right, there's a certain, like, personally, there's a certain type of artistic vibe that I get from artistic people such as yourself, right? And I'm looking at this painting, and in my head, it's screaming out to me, what kind of art-enhancing drugs are you taking for things to be drawn with such detail and such color and such creativeness, if I can put it that way? Like, what kind of drugs are you taking, if you're taking any? You know, because I know there's always a hype about artists taking drugs. I know Leonardo da Vinci took opium and whatever. And so I would like to know, like, the modern day artists, what type of things are they using?
Well, to paraphrase one of my favorite artists, I don't use drugs, I am drugs. That is from Salvador Dali. And meaning behind that is, pretty much, you don't really need to have, you don't really need to take mind-altering substances to access the deeper parts of your mind.
Okay, cool.
Basically, this is what I feel someone on drugs would say, but yeah.
With Creators Inc., we want to do a challenge between me, Kirsch, and the artist. So basically, an idiot to trying to do what the artist is trying to do, which is me, unfortunately. A person who knows stuff about art, Kirsch, because she knows stuff about art. And then the artist, in which in this case is Michael Anderson. So the thing that we're all going to do, all three of us are going to partake in drawing a simple face. Not simple for me, but the face we'll be doing is this gentleman here. His name is Kurt Cobain. Apparently he's a singer. No, I'm kidding, I know who he is. He's a dude that's dead, he played for Nirvana. So we're gonna draw his face, and yeah, this should be interesting.
So while we were drawing Kurt Cobain, Michael decided to show us some of his other art skills, known as dancing. Although, he should rather stick to art, I feel, and so does Kirsch. Hey Kirsch?
Yes, I do.
Competition, we had to draw Kurt Cobain, and then Michael will show you what he drew. Well done, let's give him a round of applause. Not much of a crowd in here, is there? And then, next up, her drawing. Not too bad, not too bad. A for effort. She missed the Club 27, as you can see. Mark's deducted for that.
Sorry.
Club 27. Even Michael missed Club 27. I think I'm the only one who had the R for that. Okay.
Peter's drawing. Let's see what you have. Not too shabby, not too shabby. The one eye's a bit skew, but I mean, I think we can go for it.
Since they cheated and all waited for Michael, he won. So our punishment, he's actually being very gentlemanlike about it. He just wants a tube of lube, I think. I don't know what he's going to use a tube of lube for, Mark. What did he want?
As long as I can paint with it.
Okay, what did he really want though?
A tube of black paint.
Tube of black.
I need that.
So we're gonna buy a tube of black paint. I don't know what he's gonna use it for, but
lube.
There you go. And then we'll just give that to him. So this is Michael Anderson. Be sure to follow him on Facebook, Michael Anderson.
Art and stuff.
Art and stuff. And then just friend him at Michael Anderson.
Hi guys. So our winner, Michael, will be drawing a penis on Peter's face.
So basically, Michael was not the only person to think about this. It was Kirsch's idea to do this. So, what an asshole she is.
In public, in a store, and he will be walking around for the rest of the day with a penis on his face.
And yes, I'm still buying the lube.
Nice. You
got
which one?
No!
Oh, shit, it's in the facial hair. I'm sorry. I think that's pretty phallus shaped.
My mother watches this, guys.
Oh, sorry. Can you just get some shading going on there? There you go. Oh man, it's quite hardcore.
Look at this guy. Come on. I don't know which way to look.
Thanks guys!
I don't think they'll recognize me.
It's huge. It's really big.
Oh no.
This is a baby looking at me.